Hey, what's going on, fam? Good morning. And a happy good morning here from Fort Stewart's RV Park. They call it Holbrook Pond. It is a beautiful area, and I plan on giving you guys a little tour around. That was the original plan. But that might not be the case because today, this morning, is actually the last time I'm going to drive Black Pearl. She has served us well. But it's time to make a change.
Take me arms, do just what you want. You're the one I trust. I belong to you, and I'll always be around.
Hey fam, I'm back. I am running some final errands in Black Pearl. This is not a eulogy. I remember the day I bought Black Pearl and told people we was gonna be taking, you're gonna use it to pull a travel trailer all across these United States full time. There was a lot of congratulations and there was a lot of naysayers and stuff. And let me just be honest with you, the naysayers were right. You should not try to pull a 7,000 pound travel trailer with a half ton. We had our limitations. We had some scary moments and stuff like that. But by the grace of God, we got through it safely. But here we are, 8,500 miles later. I don't know if it's exactly 8,500 miles, but I kept an extensive journal of every location we went to and the distance between each one. So I'm going to add them up and probably put it right here, or just put them in the description box or something. Each individual stop and stuff. But I bet you it's very close. I know the last time I checked, it was like 7,000 miles. And that was like 3 RV parks ago. So it may be more than that, but at least, around, I'm gonna say at least 8,500 miles later. All we've had was that one flat tire. Thank you, knock on wood. Thank you God for that. Thank you for the blessings and the protection. But yeah, she served us well, but I wouldn't say I recommend her or anything like that. She's good on gas. I keep on saying she. Why do people call trucks she? Do women call trucks she? Or do they call it he? I don't know. It's kind of a close relationship with our trucks and stuff. But Peggy and I have plans. We have goals. We have dreams that involve continuing into full-time RV and to do it at an even bigger level. So in order to do that, one of the first things we need is a truck that can handle what our goals are. So that being said, we have the truck. I don't have a name for it yet, but as soon as I leave here, I'm going to go pick up the truck. Now, if you have been looking at the truck market for trucks big enough and strong enough to pull RVs, you know those vehicles are few and far between. With that recent surge in RV purchases and more people getting out there RVing, it is much, much harder to find a truck. And dealerships are not willing to really haggle with you so much on the big, strong trucks. But I was able to find one, and I was able to find one that fits our needs and our goals. Now, over the past few months, when people hear that I'm looking at getting a bigger truck, I have gotten all kind of great advice. Especially from Mr. Banks, he's talking about like tongue weight and hitch weight and stuff like that. So make sure you know I kept that in mind. I did not get the truck that he suggested, but I got a truck that fulfilled the requirements that he warned me about. So I know y'all wondering, like, okay, when are we gonna see this truck? Well, we're about to see it right now. So there she is. I'm saying she again. There she is. This is Peggy and mine, or Peggy and I. This is our 2021 Dodge Ram. It's got the 6.7 liter Cummins turbo diesel engine. So I'm gonna just give you a little quick overview of the thoughts behind this selection and how we went from an F-150 to Ram 2500 heavy duty. Alright fam, so we chose this vehicle based on the three P's that I was looking at when I started shopping for a truck. Now the first P is power. Now this has power in spades. It could tow up to over 19,000 pounds, and so that covers just about any fifth wheel out of a three-quarter ton. For three-quarter ton trucks, that's about the top of the line. That Cummins turbo diesel engine is super powerful, and you're not gonna be able to tow any kind of weight like that without having a diesel engine in your vehicle, no matter what size truck you got. So we got the power part covered in spades. Now, just as important as power, and perhaps even more important, is the payload. Now, the payload is the amount of weight that you could press down on the truck itself. Now, that's gonna be very, very important should you decide to get a fifth wheel, because that fifth wheel is mounted in the bed of the truck and gonna be pressing down on your rear suspension. And so, Peggy and I are very well aware of the amount of hitch weight that we are able to pull with this, and we'll be picking out our upgraded RV based on the amount of hitch weight we're able to pull. So we have that understanding, and I appreciate all the advice that people have given us about making sure we take that into account when picking out our vehicle. And of course, just as important, if not more important than power and payload, is price. You have to get something you can afford. Everybody wants to get the biggest and the best and the strongest, so they won't have to worry about upgrading or anything like that, or being able to select everything you want to get RV-wise. But that's not something that Peggy and I have a luxury of doing. We have to make sure we get something that's within our budget, because we are both retired and we just want to be able to not have to worry about whether we're going to be able to take care of what we want to take care of. So this fell into that area right there, and we're very, very fortunate and blessed to have it. Now, it's not just the power that makes this truck very different from the Black Pearl, the Ford F-150 we had. The size is tremendously different. There's definitely gonna be a little learning curve by getting readjusted to driving something this size. When I got Black Pearl, I was like, man, this truck is huge. I really had no idea at the time what a huge truck was. This isn't so big. There are plenty of bigger trucks out here, but it is much larger. If you've seen Black Pearl, or you've seen us out there with Black Pearl, the comparison is gonna be obvious and everything. We also have a full crew cab. Now before, in order to get something in and out of the back seat, we had to open up the front door and then open up the back door from the inside. Well, that's no longer the case. We have a full back seat with this crew cab, and the amount of leg room back there is, what Peggy say, amazing. If we should decide to carry some people around with us, that is not going to be a problem. We had that issue when we was driving my sister-in-law in California. And another more important reason than all those others combined is the safety. Black Pearl was a wonderful truck that served us well, but it just wasn't safe for us to do what we were doing, and we wouldn't recommend it for anybody else. This is a vehicle that has much more pulling power, much more stopping power, allows us to maintain better control of the trailer while we're driving. You see these fully extended out mirrors and stuff. We have the ability to see more of the trailer while we're driving. There's the exhaust brake system when going downhill. We'll be able to maintain more control while going uphill. It was just so many more things that if you're going to do this for a long period of time, like Peggy and I plan on doing, you want to make sure you're doing it right. You want to make sure you're doing it safely. I realized that we wasn't doing it in the best and most safe way possible. We were just very anxious to get out there, and we learned a lot. And one of the things we learned is that we need a better truck. So we have this, and this is going to be able to serve for the current trailer and for our upgrade when it does come in. And that's extremely important. Make sure you guys are doing the right thing to protect you, your family, and your investment, and do this RV thing safely. So now I'm going to go ahead and pick up Peggy. Peggy hasn't even seen it yet. I'm going to go pick up Peggy, and then we're going to come back and share with you guys what we think. All right, fam.
Hi, family.
Hey, what's going on, fam?
Welcome back to the channel.
Well, this is the... Welcome back, fam. Yes, as Peggy said, but this is the first video from the big truck that I just showed you. We are sitting in the Ram. We don't have a nickname for it yet.
White Lightning.
Well, I was thinking about that, but I was like...
Everybody does that.
I was thinking about that, but we'll consider painting it, and then do I change the name after I paint it, or after I get it wrapped, or whatever else? I don't know, but hey, we'll figure out. Maybe we just, hey, what y'all suggest? Give me a suggestion for a...
Yeah, y'all help us name her.
give us a suggestion, yeah. Since Black Pearl is gone.
Yeah, I know I don't care about cars at all. Like, I told Donald, I was like, go... and get whatever you like, as long as it could tow what we have, right?
Mm-hmm.
Or what we're getting.
Exactly.
And we will be upgrading at the end of next month. So, yeah. So I just told him to make sure that whatever he got could tow what we're getting. And we're not upgrading after this. Like, we're done with the upgrading part of RV life. So this is going to be it for us. Unless, you know... we have to, like, we would really have to be forced into it. So when he went out, now he wasn't even expecting to get this truck.
No.
And he went in there and they were having a March Madness sale and the price was just too good to pass up. And so if he's happy, I'm happy.
Yes.
That's how it is.
I'll tell you what though. So we was at Holbrook Pond on Fort Stewart when I brought home the truck.
Yeah.
And we were still out there camping. And so we went ahead and towed the trailer down to our storage area. And when I tell you, the difference is ridiculous.
Yes.
I mean, I was doing 75. I know I ain't supposed to drive that fast, but I was doing 75 with like no problem whatsoever. I didn't feel like nervous or anything. The sway was down. Everything was down. It was just a much better experience and a much better drive. And I just feel very confident that this truck can handle anything I throw at it. So that's the good thing.
Yeah.
That's a good thing. We got some stuff in here, some space in here. We got a full back seat, as y'all can tell, stuff like that. What do you think, babe?
I like it. I mean, like I say, I'm not a fan of cars, or like, I'm not the person who like, oh, I got to have the newest this or newest that. Like, I don't care. As long as a car get me from point A to point B, I am fine. Now, I will say that this is a much more comfortable ride than before. I told Donald it was, how do you say, ergonomically correct? You know, like, I feel like I sit, but like, because I was talking to Donna for a minute and we were on that ride, and the next thing I know, I was knocked out. So the ride is better. Now, the truck is a little bit louder, but it's not enough to bother you.
You know what? I'm going to turn the truck on real quick so we can get some air in here, too, for one, but
yeah.
Give you a chance to hear what it sounds like. There you go. But that's not bad. That's not bad.
So, no, it's not bad at all for it to be a diesel truck. I love it, actually. I'm not going to lie. I do. Because, you know, he kept calling me back saying, well, what about this? And I'm like, how long we been married? I don't care about no car. Like, I don't care. But I wouldn't want him to bring a pink truck to the house. But, hey, if we had to get a pink truck to pull the RV, then that's what we would have had to do. But anyway, I love the selection he made. I think it was a good, wise decision because we want to make sure we could pull what we have. That's my only thing, if it's going to be what we need. And so he's fulfilled that. Like, we've been binge watching videos. We did our little research and everything else. So I think this truck will serve its purpose. I like it. He wants to paint it. So, you know, we'll be in St. Louis in June. Mm-hmm. And so he's like, I'm going to get it wrapped. And so I called my son because I still want to show you guys my son's car. But
yeah,
he got his car wrapped and it looks so nice.
Exactly. So he suggested wrapping or dipping or something like that. We just get it figured out. But that might just be an unnecessary expense, you know. So I'm fine with this. The truck is beautiful. The interior is spacious. I sit high. It does the work. AC, of course, everything got AC and stuff.
Yeah.
Tow mode, the good brake assist works fantastic and smoothly.
Yeah. See, that's the thing, too, I was telling Donald. I'm like, I just would rather not have leather interior.
Yeah.
I just don't like it because it seems like every car we've had the leather interior, right? Yeah. And to me, I'm like, we out in the RV, like, it's going to be cold seats. It's going to be hot seats. Ooh, hot in the summer?
Ooh.
Lord, fix it.
But these got the nice, good cloth seats, so that's not going to be an issue for us and stuff.
So
we got the truck now, fam. Part one down. Anybody who's followed us for a long time know what part two is. That trailer upgrade. And
and we'll be getting that the end of May, next month.
All right. So make sure you hit like and make sure you hit that notification bell. I haven't mentioned that in like who knows how long. Make sure you hit that notification bell, fam, so you can get the content. We've got a lot more stuff coming up. Y'all know launch day is April 8th.
Next Thursday. Hallelujah.
April 8th is launch day. We'll be full time. Right now we're at the house trying to close things out, storage, pass out, handouts, taking stuff to the food bank. Stuff like that. We're getting the whole place closed out. But April 8th is launch. My birthday is next week. We talking about going live on my
April
birthday.
5th,
on my birthday or something. So make sure y'all here for
y'all
that.
Y'all see he said on my birthday 5 times. On my birthday, on my birthday, on my birthday, on my birthday.
I just want y'all to be there, fam. It's going to be a party. You know how the Don do. You know how DJ Don does it. So hit that notification bell. So we don't even know what time we're going to do it yet. So make sure that bell is hit and everything. But that's about all we have for today, fam. We really do appreciate that. Appreciate all the support helping us get to this point. And there's a whole lot more to come.
Yes.
So that being said, we just want to thank you guys again and remind you guys, God didn't do something good for yourself.
And for others as well.
And for others as well, fam. Y'all take it easy.
Alrighty. Take me your arms. Do just what you want.